Just check over me, of course. Three critters, that's what Blake says. If we climb, I think we can get over the fence. Think you could take a look at that. Sorry, but no thanks. Why? I've got a bad feeling about it. Pussy. Okay, fine. I'll go. Please be careful, Santa. Yeah. But just in case. Wait, what's he gonna do with that screw? Checking it's electric. Oh, it is electric. This, oh man. There's electricity running through that fence. Looks like it. Then we can't get to the other side. Well, we could jump off those crates, but we wouldn't be able to get back. No, that's not yet. We don't need to do that yet. Tall fence around the part of the cargo room. Apparently there's a high voltage current running through. No! Stop! Stop! No! Sorry, I was getting absorbed there. What if they weigh too much, then what are you gonna do? Oh yeah, hadn't thought of that. Yeah, no, back up. Let's go and sort out this puzzle first.
Now we finally have all 9 picture cards. We just need to insert these cards into the slots at the front of each box.
You know which card goes in which box, yes?
Yeah, of course I do. It's really obvious. You just match our numbers to the numbers, then you pop the corresponding card in the right box. So for instance, the card with the picture of Ace on it goes into box 1. The card with the picture of Snake on it goes into box 2, and so on.
Yep, I got that.
Oh, I see.
Huh? What is it?
I'll leave the rest to you.
Hey, wait! What's wrong with him?
What is wrong with him?
Oh well, whatever. Time to solve the 9 boxes puzzle. Ace's card is in box 1, Snake's is in number 2.
Oh, I'm not even doing it.
I just need to do the same for the rest. And finally, the 9th man's card into box 9. Yeah! Oh, they opened!
Awesome.
What the? 9 pins?
Right.
I guess I'll take them with me.
Well, I know where they go. Alright, is that everything? Let's go back up these stairs. Oops. The scaffolding that supports the staircase. There's a metal panel over the outside of the window. Right. There are 6 holes here, and it looks like the pins I just found would be a perfect fit for them. The ones you found in 9 boxes, right? Well, why don't you try it? Alright, let's see what happens, I think. Why? Well, some of them little. Yeah, 3 and 6. I wonder if there's some kind of rule that determines which light goes on. Well, I put 2, 4, and 6. Yeah, I've got that. You think? You think maybe it's the digital route? The digital route? 2 + 4 + 6 = 12. The digital route of 12 is 3. Therefore, light 3 turns on. Oh, alright, okay, yeah. Okay, let's do it. There's one other thing I'd like to check. Well, if he wants to try, he's certainly welcome to. So, you put 1, 2, and 3, 6, 7, 8 on the bottom. Oh, they turned off. Therefore the light 3 turns off. Oh, yeah. Okay, yep. Fine. We can do this. Yes, I want to give it a try. I mean, you know, it's all to do with these lights. Well, no, but I figured we could try and see if we can turn them all on, you know? I figured something gotta happen when we can... Yes? Come on! Yes, yes, yes. I have got it. Right, okay, so let's start with the same ones as before. This is gonna be harder than it seems, I think. Aww. 4 plus 5 4 plus 5 is 9 plus 6 is 15 1 plus 6 is 6. Why didn't that work? Oops. Okay, 1 plus 7 plus 8 is right. So this should turn 7 on. 8. 9 plus 6, 15. 15 plus 4, that'll turn on number 8. That turned on 1. What? Okay, 5 plus 4 is 9. Plus 3. No. 9 plus. Right, that's 9. Plus 7 is 16. 16. Plus 1 is 17. Right. 4. No, shit. Right. 9. Right, wait, that makes 12 then. That should make 3. 2 plus... So 5 plus, say, 7. 5 plus 7 is 12 plus 2. Oh wait, do these both add up to 3 then? 5 plus 6. 5 plus 6 is 11, 1 plus 1 is 2. That was 4 instead of 3, okay. 9 plus 8. What's 9 plus 8? 17. 17 plus 6 is 23. That makes 5. 6. 8 and 9. That should make 5. What about 7 plus 3 is 10. Plus, and 5 will make 15, which will make 6. Can we make 3 and 8? Well, we could do 10 and 2 would make 3. And 10 and 9, yeah. Ooh, I figured it out, I think. Let's see if this actually works. Ten, 12 is 3. 10. Oh no, that would have shown me a 7. Shit. Oh, friggin' hell. 9 plus 1, 10 plus 7. Yes! Oh, that was a mental math lesson. Oh no, I thought there was going to be a key. All the lights are on and the shutters opened up. Hey, does that mean... yeah, we've got to do it again. Man, I thought I was doing so well. So did I. Oh, look at this. Look at the lines. 9 holes. And there's an F up above them. I don't know what the F means, but I do know one thing. This time there are 9 holes, so we need to insert 9 pins. Man, that's boring. Well, why don't you just try it, alright? F. I don't know what F means, but... I guess they've all got to add up. The same thing. No, oh no, 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 I know how to do this. 5. They'll all add up to 15. Just put everything that adds up to 10 opposite each other. If I just figured that out, I'm going to be so impressed with myself. Oh no. That's not right, is it? Wait, they all had a right way too. No, maybe I just need to swap some of them around. Yes! No way. I'm impressed. I am really impressed. I'm buzzing about that. I didn't use Google at all. I did it. That was all my own smart. Like, can you believe it? Oh, I'm so happy. Power's now on. It looks like there's electricity going to the monitor on the top now. Alright, let's see if we can activate the device on the top. Can you believe I just did that? I'm buzzing. A green button, a red button, and a lever. I wonder what these are gonna do. I think this might help. What the hell is this? Where did you find this? What is that? Where did you find it? What is it? Found it when you were messing around with the pinholes. Looks like instructions for this thing. According to what it says here, this thing's remote control for that. That? Yeah, that. Yeah, I mean, I kind of figured that was going to be some sort of crane game or something. What's it called? The machine over there, apparently it's called the Pushmaster 5000. Are you serious? Whatever, so what are we supposed to do with the Pushmaster 5000? You see the coffin over there on top of the crate? Yeah? Don't you want to know what the deal is with it? I do. You want to check it out? Yeah. Alright. How do you think we're gonna get there? Well, Well, there were some crates on the right side of the fence that piled up like stairs. And maybe if we make a path to the coffin from there, how would we do that? Line up the crates, I guess. Yes? That sounds about right. I guess this is just another one of Zero's puzzles. Yeah. Anyway, let's give it a shot. Oh, looks like the Pushmaster 500 runs off the battery, so keep it from using up its energy too fast. It's been programmed so that it'll only start moving once its path has been completely programmed in. Alright, I'll keep that in mind. New material has been added to the file screen. Right. Let's have a look at the file screen, shall we? Oops. Instructions for the machine. Yes. In order to prolong battery life, it's advised you first simulate your actions before carrying them out. So we've got to figure the whole thing out before we press go, basically. I think. Pull the lever to begin the simulation. Right, you can move in four directions. You cannot move diagonally. If it exceeds the battery life, it will reset. So you've only got a limited amount of move. Cannot lift heavy objects. It can lift the wooden crates, but not the steel crates, I guess. Reset, quit, start. Right. I'm ready. The monitor shows a top-down view of the area where, once I send my orders to, I'll pull the lever. Okay. This is a reset button. It allows me to start over again. Alright, let's give this a try. Sure thing, just keep in mind that there is a limit on the battery. The battery dies after 50 moves. At least that's what it says in the manual. Keep in mind that it can't move the heavy metal crates, yes. When it's touched. Oh, okay. But we're allowed to reset it. Okay, that's good. We can only push one crate. So, right, let's... oh no, that's gonna get stuck. Oh, every square counts as a move. Oh, friggin' hell. Right, reset. Yes, I've nailed it. I am nailing it. I can't believe it, I did it. No hints again. I didn't even use the hint in the corner. I'm just a logic genius. There was a level like this in one of the Pokemon games, but it was It was one of those levels where you're on ice and you've got to stop at the right like non-icy patch, and I never got past it, and I remember I was fuming at it, but I think I've got better logic since I was like 10. Right. I'm so happy with myself right now. I'm buzzing just because I could solve a couple of puzzles. I never solve puzzles. Like, not well. What's going to be in the coffin, though? That's another question.
Mummy!
Oh. Oh, is it that cursed mummy?
Oh.
Just kidding.
Oh, you fucker.
Really? Whatever. Just open it.
Is he not even
okay,
opening?
Okay.
A small key and...
Oh my god.
A gun?
Shit.
Yeah, a revolver.
It looks pretty old.
I wonder if this is a replica.
This thing is... Are these real bullets?
Oh my god.
Oh, if this is real... Oh.
I didn't expect that.
You're not gonna take it?
Of course not. All something like this is gonna do is cause more trouble.
Someone's gonna take it.
It's a powerful weapon that gives one person a huge advantage. Something like that would be way too dangerous to have around. We're in enough danger already.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Maybe Zero put this gun here, hoping that something like that might happen.
Ace is gonna take
it. In other words, maybe he put it here to make us fight each other.
In that case, we should most certainly leave it here. I, for one, have no desire to let Zero control me.
Me neither. Okay, we've got that figured out. But you aren't gonna leave that key in there, are you?
No, we need the key.
Of course not. We'll take that with us.
Someone is gonna have the gun. That is just not there for no reason. Right, let's go. Is that everything? Right. To the door.